An old man turned 98. He won the lottery, died the next day. It's a black fly in your Chardonnay. It's a death row pardon, 2 minutes too late. And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? Snack rain on your wedding day. It's a free ride when you've already paid. The good advice that you just didn't take. And who would have thought it figures? It's to play it safe, was afraid to fly. He packed his suitcase and kissed his kids goodbye. I waited his whole damn life to take that flight. And as the plane crashed down, he thought, well, isn't this nice? And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? It's like praying on your wedding day. It's a free ride when you've already paid. It's the good advice that you just didn't take. And who would have thought it figures? Well, life has a funny way, sneaking up on you when you think everything's okay and everything's alright. And life has a funny way of helping you out when you think everything's gone wrong and everything blows up in your face. Traffic jam when you're already late. A no smoking sign on your cigarette break. It's like 10,000 spoons when all you need is a knife. It's meeting the man of your dreams and then meeting his beautiful wife. And isn't it ironic? Don't you think? A little too ironic. And yeah, I really do think. Like rain on your wedding day. It's a free ride when you've already paid. It's the good advice that you just didn't take. And who would have thought it figures? Well, life has a funny way, sneaking up on you. Life has a funny way of helping you out. Helping you
new. What? I'm eating my rice lunch. Come in, what is it?
You don't look ticket.
I thought I said come in. Where's your inhaler?
No, I don't have asthma.
Inhaler, you know, breathe, breathe, puff, puff, good, good. Where is it?
I don't have asthma.
But you know breath. Ah, I know what to do. I know. Wait there, babushka, wait there. Now, I've been saving these for the most dire of situations. My oils.
I did. Okay, we have one for relaxation. Energy, headache relief.
Ah, oxygen. Come here, child, come.
Aha, there we go, there we go. All better, all better.
What are you...
Back in my country, Splunk the String Slovakia, we did not have the handy inhalers. We dropped dirt on our wounds and prayed to the borscht that we would not have fever in the winter. That's how I lost my pinky toes. Now don't move muscle. Ah, what is it? Ah, there we go. This ought to do it. Okay. Stop moving!
No, stop it!
Babushka! She is cured! Well, that was a mistake. Hey, let me call your mother. Stop being drama queen. Hello, Julie?
Yes, it is. I am here with your daughter, and she is seeming to be having an asthma attack, but I can't find her inhaler.
No, she doesn't have asthma or an inhaler. What's going on?
Well,
is she alright?
She's perfectly fine. She's just turning slightly blue. But
what?
I can use another one of the children's inhalers.
No, she doesn't have asthma. No, stop.
Okay,
don't do that.
Open up.
It appears to be broken. here, take this. Wow, she isn't the brightest. Open up, Inyushka.
Oh, it won't go down.
Oh, it won't go down. It's simply gag reflex. Just swallow, Suka!
Wow, these children today are so melodramatic. Okay, here we go! How is she not dead?
What?
What is going on?
Asthma!
She doesn't have asthma! Call someone!
I can't.
What do you mean you can't?
A parent has to allow it.
I do! Can't you tell that I do?
That was not clear. 911!
For God's sakes!
Hello! Well, I guess there's one thing left to do.
Thank you. What are you doing?
Put hole in the neck of victim. Let evil spirits out and air plow in. It has over 0.001% success rate.
Where on earth could that ever be possible?
Who said we were on earth?
What?
What?
You just said
Look, the doctors are here. No, I think I'm feeling better now.
What's that now?
Oh, I just, thank God your asthmatic daughter's all right.
She doesn't have asthma!
Well, that's what happened. It turns out that I must have swallowed a leaf when the snow hit me in the face, or at least a bit of a leaf, and it just went through my system very slowly and scarily. But we went to the hospital, you know, to check that everything was okay, and we were there from about 12:30 to 7:30, all for them to say, oh, she's fine. But, hey, I'm still standing.
Never know what it's like. The blood like winter freezes just like ice. And there's a cold lonely light that shines from you. You'll find it like a wreck you hide behind that mask you use. Did you think this fool could never win? Well look at me, I'm coming back again. I got a taste of love in a simple way. You need to know I am still standing. You'll just fade away. don't you know I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. No, I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. Once I never could have hoped to win, started down the road leaving me again. Threats you made were meant to cut me down, and if my love was just a circus, you'd be a clown by now. No, I'm still standing better than I ever did. Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. Don't you know that I'm still standing better than I ever did? Looking like a true survivor, feeling like a little kid. I'm still standing after all this time, picking up the pieces of my life without you on my mind. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah. I'm still standing, yeah, yeah, yeah.
Dude, you're me. You know sneaking up on us is a death sentence.
Touche.
So?
So?
So? Don't you have any questions for me?
Not really. Well,
there's one thing I need to know.
Yes, yes, ask anything.
Well, no, I shouldn't ask you this.
I'm you! You can literally ask me anything!
Okay. Should I grow my hair out? That was your big question. Are you that dumb that you can't figure out what the answer is going to be?
So, no?
Do you realize how expensive time travel is?
Do I look like I understand the intricacies of finance to you?
Right. I should have known. You paid our sister $20 to hang out with you.
Well, at least you're back in a simpler time.
Simple? You think coming back here to fix your mess is simple?
Jeez, lighten up, dude.
That reminds me. This has got to go.
What even is this?
No one knows. And when we're done here, you better get on the elliptical.
Are you calling me fat?
No, I'm calling me fat.
But isn't you me?
Ah, right, there are some things I need to talk to you about.
Okay.
How did you... Anyway, you need to stop holding yourself to impossible standards.
What? I don't do that.
Oh, really? May 25th, 2007. Forced self to be the first baby who could walk at 15 days old. And failed.
Psst, you can't prove that.
How can't I?
This is meticulous.
Yes, we are a perfectionist through and through.
Well, is that all?
Oh, there's one more thing. Under the pillow? Not such a good place to hide a diary. Remember what we wrote June 3rd, 2018?
June 3rd.
Yes, my suggestion is to prop it under that picture of Ellie that's crooked.
We never fixed this? I thought we were perfectionists.
We are, but we're also pretty lazy.
I guess so.
Hey! She's gone. I never had the chance to ask her if dabbing was still a thing. Well, it's probably for the best.
Never do that again!
Have you ever heard the song Stairway to Heaven, or at least heard of it? Thought so. Well, my school has one, but it's more like Stairway to the Underworld. Here's some background. My school is 9 floors tall, and, well, there is a penthouse above it, so I guess that adds some floors. Don't ask me why anyone would choose to live above a middle school, high school. It's beyond me. But anyway, in our building, there is a lot of staircases, or there are a lot of staircases. I haven't been in real school in months. Don't judge me. But anyway, there are a lot of staircases, and one of them is called Center Stairwell. Now, this is a special staircase because it doesn't go to some floors. It goes to the basement, the first floor, the second floor, and the 7th, 8th, and 9th. So floors 3 to 6? Nothing. If the doors did open, they would just lead you to a brick wall. And me, as a 7th grader at the time, that did not bode well for my anxiety. So, naturally, I was always quite nervous in that stairwell. And I remember one day I was walking up the stairs, and my chest starts tightening, and my breath starts to, like, accelerate, like I'm panting like a cavalier. And I'm panicking even more because I'm like, oh crap, I can't breathe. This is not good. So I'm walking with my friends and they're like, you good? And I'm like, totally, totally fine. Which is something that is very characteristically like me, saying you're fine when you're dying inside. Anyways, so I decide I need to sit down because I have like a 15-pound backpack on. And I am on a full stomach because we just had lunch and I am tired. So I sit down and I'm about to die in my imagination because I can't really breathe. And at this point we are on the 5th floor, which if you remember our little backstory is directly in the middle and does not open. So I'm trapped and I'm about to have a panic attack and my two friends go opposite directions, one up to the 7th floor and one down to the 2nd floor to try to find somebody. And I'm just sitting there alone with my like 15-pound backpack, just like, we're good, it's okay. But then we get the nurse and she like walks me like down the stairs, but I'm still not breathing. I probably look very blue. I'm not doing well. So we're walking down the stairs and we get to the 2nd floor, which is the next door that opens. And my sister is there with her friends on her school break. And she's like, oh, hey, someone's not breathing. That's cool. Oh, shoot. It's my sister. So she's trying to help me. And basically, if you've never had this problem before of, breathing malfunctions, then you'll probably know that, The biggest piece of advice people will give you is just breathe. As if you haven't been doing it your whole life. Wow, that's such good advice. I feel so much better. But anyway, clearly I survived. And that wasn't the end. No, no, no. This happened multiple times. So my mom was like, we should take you to the doctor. So we go to a doctor, and they're like, it's not asthma. That's for sure. And long story short, they say, it's not asthma. It's vocal cord dysfunction, we think. We think. Ah, that's fun. So basically, if you don't know what vocal cord dysfunction is, it's basically if you overexert yourself or exercise too much or just get really stressed, which is things I do all the time. Your vocal cords decide to like be really mean and just swell up and close your airway. And you can't use an inhaler or like a puffer or anything. The cure, breathing exercises. So when you're like dying and you need to be able to breathe oxygen again, this is their suggestion. Do this. This is a lesson. Purse your lips. But I found my own cure. Just don't exercise. It's been working great. Bye now.
The clown is the president now. It's just one ship. And I gained 20 pounds and my commute is less than 17 steps. That's 2020. I might look business on top, but on the bottom, I assure you I'm not. My camera's off because I'm insecure. That's 2020. A midday snack is basically lunch. All of this screen time packs more than a punch. If Trump wins, that is it, I am done. We just need Obama, not persona non grata. Trump is racist and homophobic and transphobic and xenophobic, and you know, just an absolute waste. That's 2020. Wearing a mask is not to save a life. It is to declare if you are left or right. 1 million dead and 1 million more. Vaccine by Easter, vaccine by Christmas.
Buy homes while the interest is low. Ignore the NASDAQ and the Dow Jones, it's a